Good evening. Please remain standing for the invocation which will be offered by Bishop Donald Jackson.
Let us pray. Dear God, creator of heaven and earth and all things therein, as we join heaven to celebrate these students who have met this milestone, we first give you thanks for the families and friends that have traveled near and afar. We thank you for traveling mercy. We'd like to thank God also for all those that played a part in their lives in acquiring this degree. We ask that you bless our president and his cabinet, the board of trustees, every faculty and staff. We give you thanks, O God, for how you kept us from harm's way, kept us from sickness and disease. Now, Lord, we ask that you bless each student. We thank you for how they persevered to make this point. And Lord, we pray a blessing upon each and every one, that there may be a door of opportunity open to them, that they may be able to utilize the skills and the knowledge that they have acquired from this university. It is in the matchless name of Jesus Christ I pray. Amen.
Seems to matter. the better. I do believe that I've been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
Before we begin, I would like to call your attention to the commencement ceremony etiquette requests listed in your program, and to remind everyone that if you leave the ceremony whilst it is in progress, please exit by the northwest entrance, and remember, you may not be allowed to return. Also, once the degrees have been awarded, the audience will please remain seated until all the graduates have recessed. Thank you for your cooperation. Welcome to our spring commencement. The academic procession was led by the bearer of the faculty mace. The faculty mace leads the academic procession at commencement and on other special ceremonial occasions. This evening, the faculty mace was carried by Dr. K. Lorimore Belanger, N.B. Baroudy Professor of Marketing. With us this evening, we have some special guests whom I wish to recognize at this time. First, I would like to present the First Lady of Francis Marion, Mrs. Folly Carter. Mrs. Carter, will you please stand? The Board of Trustees for Francis Marion University is made up of men and women from throughout the state who give up their time generously and without compensation. It is our pleasure to welcome some of those members to the commencement platform tonight. I shall ask each to stand when introduced and remain standing while all have been recognized. Chair of the Board of Trustees, Robert E. Lee, Class of 87, Marion. Trustee William W. Coleman, Jr., Class of 71, Florence. Trustee H. Paul Dove, Jr., Winsborough. Trustee Kenneth W. Jackson, Class of 84, Florence. Trustee Stephen N. Jones, Class of 88, Hartsville. Trustee Floyd L. Keels, 2012 Honorary Doctor of Humanities degree recipient, Lake City. Trustee George C. McIntyre, Class of 78, Bennettsville. We appreciate your leadership and for being with us tonight. The administrative officers, comprised of the vice presidents, are also seated on stage, and I shall ask each to stand when introduced. Ms. Lauren Stanton, Vice President of Institutional Advancement and Executive Director of the FMU Foundation. Dr. Charlene Wages, Vice President for Administration. Dr. Darrell L. Bridges, Vice President for Finance and Facilities. Dr. Christopher M. Kennedy, Vice President for Student Life. And Dr. T. Alyssa Waters, Vice President for Enrollment Management. Also seated on stage, and I shall ask each to stand when introduced, Bishop Donald Jackson, Mr. A. Glenn Gawley, Chair of the Faculty, Dr. John W. Tuttle, Director of the Honours Program and Professor of English, Ms. Allison M. Stedman, Associate Provost and Director of Graduate Programs, and Ms. Anne Williams, Registrar. And now it is my pleasure to present the president of Francis Marion University, Dr. Luther F. Carter. Dr. Carter.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. Welcome to the university's 115th commencement ceremony, celebrating the graduation of the class of 2022. You know, tonight marks the return to a number of our pre-pandemic traditions at the university. The ruffles and flourishes are back, the procession is returned, and the Alumni Association will entertain on the lawn afterward, weather permitting. Above all else, there is a sense of excitement and anticipation that has always been a part of this signature event at the university. Let me begin by describing our graduating class this weekend. Between the two ceremonies, 330 are graduating, 278 with undergraduate degrees, and 52 with graduate degrees. 33 will receive honors recognition, 12 with university honors, and 82 with Latin honors. The youngest graduate is 20 years old. The oldest graduate is 63 years old. 306 are South Carolinians. That's 93% of the graduating class. Once again, this is the highest percentage among the public universities in the state. And by the end of tomorrow, FMU will have graduated just under 25,000 alumni, over 20,000 of whom continue to live in South Carolina. That's a remarkable record for the youngest state university in South Carolina. Now, thank you. Thank you. Both of you. Now, a few comments for the graduates this evening. There are two special events tonight of unique importance to you. The first comes when the provost asks you to stand, and I have the privilege of conferring your degrees. Legally, you acquire those degrees at precisely that instant, and you should flip the tassels to the left on your mortarboard, which formally acknowledges this change in your academic status. The second event is when you cross the stage and you're officially presented as a new graduate to the trustees, the faculty, and all of our guests here this evening. It's an historically distinctive process and a very memorable one. Midway across that stage, you're going to pause and actually receive the diploma that you've earned, the result of thousands of hours of work, study, tests, examinations, and papers. By any standard, you've completed an arduous journey, culminating in that 50-foot walk across the stage. So I want you to take your time. I want you to savor every step, and I want you to soak in enough of the atmosphere to sustain those memories for the next few decades. You deserve it, and so do your friends and family here this evening. Now, all of this brings us to a little broader theme. Parents, spouses, siblings, relatives, and friends have been an important part of your education. You've done your best to never let them down. And when they ask how college was going, you invariably offered positive reassurances. You didn't want to express apprehension or anxiety, nor did you want to express a lack of self-confidence during this process. But you and I know this is a difficult university. The curriculum is rigorous. There were times when you may have been a little uncertain about your ability or your tenacity or your perseverance to stay the course. But right now, in this moment, all of that is moot. And while you should appreciate the assistance from family and friends, I want you to celebrate today for what it is. You have completed the most challenging intellectual challenge of your life. at least to date. So sit back and relish this sense of achievement. You know, there are only two other events comparable to this, in my opinion. Marriage and the birth of a child. And you accomplished this one primarily on your own. So celebrate throughout the course of the day and reflect on the magnitude of what you've accomplished. But I want you to do something else too. Think about celebrating the entire summer in the same spirit, with the same mode of jubilation and reflection. I'm going to pause here for just a second for the parents to groan. But no, I'm serious. It took you at least 4 years to get here. Give yourself a few months to appreciate it fully. And in those weeks ahead, please set aside time to reflect on what you want to do with your life, not just professionally, but personally, culturally, and socially. There's no better time to do this than having just completed this phase of your education. You know, tomorrow morning, you will wake up feeling much different about yourself than you did this morning. You will be enjoying a unique freedom and a sense of fulfillment. So this summer, take some time to travel and explore. By all means, read as much as you can for relaxation, for entertainment, for inspiration. You know, for the first time in a very long while, you get to choose your own reading materials. Think about the next phase in your life and how to put it together. It's your future. It's your future alone. Make sure that neither time nor tide nor a lack of imagination steals it from you. So how do you go about doing all of this? Well, you might start with the lyrics of the Little River Band. You have to take time to make time. Any number of people around you will be pushing you to make decisions quickly. But hey, listen to me. Take the time to slow down long enough to calibrate your direction and acquaint yourself with the new you. You know, the one with the college degree, the one with the great education, the one standing on the peak that it took you 4 long years to climb. So this summer, just take some time to make time, to move beyond the stress of the past 4 years and plan who you are and where you're going. I promise you, it'll be time well spent. Finally, in closing, let me share an observation about our faculty. Under any circumstances, they perform exceptionally. Every class, every semester, every year. They are everything a university president could envision. They're gifted scholars, masterful teachers, they're studious researchers. But especially during the past few years, as the university struggled with the problems and perils of COVID, their support and compassion for our students and for each other has been nothing less than extraordinary. I am very certain that the size of last year's graduating class and the size of this class would be much smaller were it not for their dedication during these most trying of circumstances. During the pandemic, we have all come to appreciate those throughout society who step forward to accomplish remarkable feats. From my perspective, my faculty colleagues stand at the very forefront of this group. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and join me in recognizing our own faculty for their success in educating our students during this long and very trying period. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Carter. And now we have the presentation of our Premier Academic Award, the William H. Blackwell Award. I call upon Ms. Lauren B. Stanton, Vice President of Institutional Advancement and Executive Director of the FMU Foundation, to present this award.
Good evening. Will Sophia Anastasia Metropolis please join me on stage? The William H. Blackwell Award, named in memory of the founding chairman of the Francis Marion University Foundation, is given by the foundation to the student or students who exemplify excellence in scholarship and who have attained, in all academic work, the highest academic achievement among those receiving baccalaureate degrees. Although all baccalaureate degree recipients during the year are eligible for consideration, this award is presented only at the spring commencement ceremony. In recognition of your outstanding academic record, Francis Marion University presents the 2021-2022 William H. Blackwell Award to Ms. Sophia Anastasia Metropolis, native of Florence, South Carolina, and double majored in supply chain management and finance. Congratulations on this memorable achievement.
Before we begin the conferral of degrees this evening, I am pleased to announce that honor medallions will be presented to those graduating with university honors during the distribution of undergraduate degrees by Dr. John Tuttle, Director of the Honors Program and Professor of English. Now I call upon the President of the University to come forward. Will the candidates for master's and bachelor's degrees please rise? Mr. President, I am pleased to present these candidates for their respective degrees. Each candidate has completed the required course of study, and each has been approved by the faculty.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the faculty for Francis Marion University, I confer upon you your respective degrees with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto. Congratulations.
I wish to ask Ms. Allison Stedman, Associate Provost and Director of Graduate Programs, and Ms. Anne Williams, Registrar, to come forward to assist in the presentation of diplomas for the graduate degrees. Will the graduates come forward to receive their diplomas? And the rest of you.
School of Health Sciences, Master of Speech Language Pathology. Hannah Nicole Clements. Catherine Elizabeth Covington. Tara Deese. Alexis Sherman Gadson. LaDasia Len Graham. Jaquetta Montes Jacobs. Riley Joe Klockow. Deja Simone Linen. Tania Alexis McCray. Velma J. Mewborn Bender. Cheryl Leanna Muldrow. Hannah Shelby Pels. Denisha Laquasia Prince. Rachel Whitney Rame. Ashley Nicole Sawyer. Molly Louise Scott. Ashlyn Kelsey Smith. Ian Arthur Stokum. Lauren Michelle Sternick. Caitlin Campbell Talon. Jada Tierra Williams. Allison Marie Windham. School of Business, Master of Business Administration. Jennifer Nathalie Massey. Bijal Shishakant Patel. Sydney Moran Tibbs. At this time, we present the candidates for the undergraduate degrees. I wish to ask Dr. T. Alyssa Warders, Vice President for Enrollment Management, to come forward to assist in the presentation of the diplomas for the undergraduate degrees. Will the graduates please come forward to receive your diplomas?
School of Business, Bachelor of Business Administration, Skylar Elizabeth Atkinson Muldrow. Kyle Robert Barkus. Juliana M. Barfield, summa cum laude. Javier Bello Perez. Brandon James Bevan. Mauricio Castorino. Kendrick Colin Chapman. Robert Fulmer Collins. Sydney Ann Connor, magna cum laude. Pierre-Henri Jean de Cavelle, cum laude. Stephanie B. Derrick. Qualia Flegler. Deja Onye Green. Richard C. Green. Jessica Taylor Horn. Prentice Granger Howell, cum laude. Javoris Dontrez Jackson, magna cum laude. Alexander Jurgensen, cum laude. Reese Kleinhelter. Caleb Lee Knotts. Lindsay Claire Larimore. Alexis Nicole Lawson. Jordan McKenzie Lockhart. James Allen Martino Jr. Jeffrey Todd Maddox. Kelsey Danielle McLaughlin. Madison Gabrielle McPhail, cum laude. Matthew Acock Mendelson. Erman Mikhail, cum laude. Sophia Anastasia Metropolis, summa cum laude. Jaden Robert Morrison. Robert Coleman Norris. Sarah Brittany Peterite, cum laude. Benjamin Caleb Poston. Tyla Quick. Michael Christian Riles, magna cum laude. Brock Robert Rogers. Lindsay Cameron Ruff. Vincent Mario Simpson. Chandler Holt Sox. Michael McClure Thompson. Albert Edwin Underwood IV. Jalen Malik White. Emily Ann Yarborough. Alvaro Zamora Sanchez, magna cum laude. Bachelor of Science, Jonathan E. Anderson. Christopher Eugene Jacobs, magna cum laude with university honors. Mark Jared Lights. Amanda Catherine Reese. Amber Megan Spies. School of Health Sciences, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Tyvala Barnwell. Ernest Matthew Barentine. Brianna Nicole Birch. Jacob Adam Blackwell. Erica Marie Dallas. Victoria Frazier. Shelby Cole Frost. Kiana Tanise Gurley. Hunter Allen Harden. Peyton Alyssa Hartfield, magna cum laude. Verena Catherine Jack. Tamara Jackson, cum laude. Heather Grace Jeffords. Xavier Lee Kennedy. Brittany Lee. Lorraine Abby Lewis. Stephanie Ann Lovett. Addie Leanne May. Emily Grace McDonald. Desmond Marquise McFadden. Mason Art McKnight. Joanna Vivian Metropolis, cum laude. Bailey Nodrick. Sharon Paula Kirthy. Carson Faye Raydell. Parker William Rao. Tierra Celia Ritter. Alicia Arian Simmons. Emily Grace Simmons. Ashley Nicole Smith. Emily Elizabeth Smith. Madison Taylor Smith, magna cum laude. Sally Hope Snyder. Hunter Elizabeth Stone. Haley Hux Van Dyne. Brianna Romeald Williams, magna cum laude with university honors. Ashlyn Elizabeth Wood. Bachelor of Science in Healthcare Administration, Alicia Alford. Brianna Charday Bowers. Nikaira Brown. Brittany Ramisha Brunson. Sierra Renee Emily Cruz. Diamond Simone Gamble. Zaria Samore Gant. Tajane Maisha Lunn. Janasia Osborne. Brianna Roof. Ray Darrell Teja. Dariana Monet Timmons. Jacob Lindsay Tootle. Christina Haley Wintler.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of spring 2022. To the members of the audience, for reasons of courtesy and safety, we ask that you remain seated until the academic procession and all of the graduates have recessed. Following these proceedings, there will be a reception for the graduates and guests on the lawn outside of the University Centre. Now, as we conclude, graduates, you have friends and family here tonight who have supported you for many years. Please stand and show your appreciation. And now to give the benediction, Bishop Donald Jackson.
Now may the grace of our God and the fellowship of his Holy Spirit, may he dispatch his heavenly angels to give us traveling mercy. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. In Jesus' name, amen.
This concludes our spring 2022 commencement. Please remain seated until all the graduates have recessed.
Walking.